realize that we literally forget to breathe as we naturally should.
Should we practice that, ladies? Because sometimes when we get fearful, we breathe out here. But we should be doing deep level breathing, and sometimes we've not learned to just breathe, okay? I want you guys just to breathe while I tell you this point, Marie. You can close your eyes. I'm going on a vacation in my mind to another space and time. I'm gonna steal away till I hear myself just breathe. Just breathing to remind myself that I'm still here and maybe you tripping. See, I'm gonna pack my bags and say goodbye without ever really leaving to all that is bothering you. Ain't bothering me too. And while I'm breathing, I'm going on a vacation in my mind. Now, ladies, snap your fingers. And I'm not taking you. God has given us rhythm in our hips. Then when we tired, all we have to do is put some shoes on. We get rhythm. I'm tired, but I put my shoes on. I got rhythm in my hips. God has given us a snapping in our fingers and a bobbing on our head to get us a point across. Emotions, we can glorify God. Bless all my soul, all the emotions that were in me. If I want to cry, I can cry unto the Lord. Okay, even crying releases stress. It releases toxins. Crying is healthy. Okay, a table over here. Y'all get this table ready?
Oh, excellent. Tell me all the benefits of exercise you can think of.
It releases stress.
Releases stress.
Sweat,
so it releases toxins.
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead.
Keeps your limbs in shape.
Oh, yeah.
So you can run for the Lord.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, yeah. And it helps you live a healthy, vibrant life.
Yes, it does. Okay. Okay, good. You get the same one? Forgiveness. Okay, we're going to come back to forgiveness because we got to go into the attitudes. Go ahead. Ooh, peace. You gotta go into the attitude, come back to that. Love. Okay. Anyway, I want you guys to get into these deep people. I want some natural things, you know, whatever.
Laughter.
Yes. Come on, let's try that.
Helps with blood pressure and everything. Laughter is good, and there's so many. I got a list of things to give you. We can go on and on and on, but would you start doing the other one you know? Go ahead.
Positive attitude.
Ooh, positive attitude. That's good. Positive attitude. Oh, because God says, let the mind be with you, within you, that's in Christ Jesus, in the mind of Christ class we just did. What sort of things are good?
What's
good.
And holy,
think on these things. So that's a positive. Okay, so we got hugs. And guess what? Just for the married ladies, I'm gonna say this. Not for us women again. I'm a whispering. Sex.
What's that?
Sex. Sex is good for your health.
Yeah, it is.
It is. It's good for your health. Helps with your heart rate. You can't afford a membership to the club. Just some burn some calories. You don't know you're burning calories. Another thing it does for you, the Bible says two shall become one flesh. You are giving him your aura, your charisma, your smearing on. Because what happens when the other lady comes, you stop having sex with him, and he starts leaning towards the other lady because she's got him. That's the power of influence. If God gave us that. You know, if they come, and let me tell you how powerful sex is, because you know when Joseph, well, when Mary was pregnant, could Joseph touch her?
No.
Because you're sharing more, he said, two shall become one flesh. That's why single women go on do not, because that causes a chasms and splits and makes you kind of crazy. Because you're longing for something that's never going to be yours, and you're not whole in an adulterous relationship because you're not in a relationship with Christ. And you don't want to open yourself up to strongholds because you're becoming one flesh. So you, when you go to church and you're shouting and you've been to an evangelist, Sister Mercy's one of her workshops, and you start shouting, go home and make love to your husband. Because that Versi evangelist, Versi's not coming in, but I'm saying the power, the anointing is now coming on that man who won't go to church. That's why not only your prayer, but your influence. And again, your influence and your impact in life. Okay, so we got breathing, we got hugs. Can everybody hug somebody next to you? 15 hugs, baby, who's your new sister? Hug somebody. Give somebody a holy hug. Now the last thing I'm going to talk about, ladies, and you got to forgive me, I need somebody to pass this information out.
Thank you, God.
The last thing I'm going to talk about is what we've gone over in the Mind of Christ class. Thank you so much, my sister. And I love that friendship is a good thing, too. You live longer, and that made me feel, endorphins were released when she came up. I went, thank you. But now we're going to switch. We got to go to the Word real fast. There are natural things that are all around you. I didn't even mention all of them. Sleep. Being still, be still and know that I am God. Sit quietly before you go on Facebook and talk to somebody. Let God tell you what you need to do about your relationship and health and all that. And let your consciousness stop getting ahead and behind you. Stay right in that moment. The Holy Ghost will come to you. He said, study. Women, study to be quiet. Study. You have to learn that. It's a tool. It's a technique. It's a power tool for you. Jesus knew he would move away. But I got to tell you, this is the most important thing. This is the Beatitudes. Real quickly, where do we find wellness in the Beatitudes? Blessed are they that are poor in spirit, for theirs is the
kingdom of God.
Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be. Blessed are they pure in heart, for they shall. Blessed are those who persecuted, for they shall be called children of God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall. Okay, so in the kingdom, you can look weak, but be rich in the kingdom. You can turn the other cheek in the kingdom and please God, because your relationship with God is more important than your pride. Because pride comes before destruction, and he will not, God, two things he hates, lying tongue and a prideful spirit. So don't mess with what God hates. If you don't like pride, then kill it. He don't like lying, no even white lies, kill it. Because lying will make you crazy, and pride will keep you from having a relationship with Christ, because he don't like it. Okay, so let's get back to this. The Beatitudes are rich with wellness principles about the kingdom of God that you can implement into your life. And by improving your relationships, by ministering and by allowing the flow of God to come through you, you're going to be operating in the kingdom of God. And I got an exhortation for you in the back. I want somebody to read it. On the back of the point, the prayer. We're going to read this exhortation about the kingdom of God. Okay, and then we're gonna do the thing up here. Anybody want to volunteer to read this? My name is Pamela Purnell. Okay, anybody want to read that? On the back of it says the kingdom of God. Anybody want to read that? You don't want to make some copies because we have lunch today, so we'll make copies. Okay. She'll give yours back. This is something I wrote. This is about the kingdom of God. This is something to think about. This is where you live. And him you live and have your very being. He says, Luke says, we are the kingdom of God.
The kingdom awaits you. An exhortation received March 11, 1997. You are my child, and I am your father. Everything I have is yours. The kingdom is yours. Access the kingdom for that you need. Access the kingdom for that you desire. The kingdom has come unto by the way of the Son through the shedding of his blood. The purchase has been made. The account is now yours in Jesus' name. It is your settlement. Claim it for your children and your children's children. The kingdom of God is rich. It has all that is of God through your faith, through your confessions, and through your prayers. Lay claim on all that is already yours. The land is fertile in the kingdom. It will produce the likeness of Christ in you, so that you will establish his kingdom in your earthly vessel as it is in the kingdom of heaven. who are denied by Jesus Christ. There is life in the kingdom. There is power in the kingdom. Amen. There is love in the kingdom. Amen. And there is light in the kingdom. Amen. The kingdom of God awaits all who dare to trust in.
Yes.
Enter in.
Yes.
His promise through sonship, yes, through relationship, through obedience, through love of God, oneself and others. The kingdom waits in prosperity.
Yes.
It waits with healing and victory.
Amen.
It waits with power. It waits in righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. The kingdom of God awaits today. The kingdom of God awaits today. All of it. Come, Holy Spirit, and take me with haste. I long for the place in the Father where I can dwell always. Come, Holy Spirit, I shall not grieve your call. I won't hesitate to open the door and enter into the holy place where I find rest. Come, Holy Spirit, show us the way to the place where Christ went to prepare for us and wait to receive us even today.
I know a place, y'all. I take you there. Ain't nobody worrying. I take you there. Ain't no smile. You know, you feel it? Wait.
Oh, no.
Because there was a place, because he said, even before he went up there, he says, you know, the kingdom of God is within you. He said it in Luke, right? But then he went to that place. He said, don't touch me, because I got to put the blood on the mercy seat that it speaks in heaven for you, so you have right and access. He says, I know a place that where I am, not when you get to heaven. And now, why wait for that? Where I am, there you may be. In him we live and move and have our very being. Can we have the rich life? Yeah. Because of Christ in us has given us that place. And when we can't, when we have difficulty getting there, he said, I'm going to send you another comforter, the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And he will take you into me. And I will take you into the Father where you already are and have already been. You moved in your perceptions. I wrote about that. It's going to be a book called Rose Petals. But I have never moved. And I have loved you with an everlasting love. Now let's do let's move to the Lord's Prayer, okay? Now let's everybody say the Lord's Prayer without reading that.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors.
Song. Celebrate good. Now, what you sing with me? Celebrate good times. Come on. Celebrate good times. Come on. Now, tell me why you read the Lord's Prayer. Read, because basically it's read it in your mind, and you didn't know to celebrate good times. Come on, with some feeling. Now look over the Lord's Prayer when we say, Our Father. I want you to close your eyes. I'm going to sing a song I wrote. Hope I remember. And I want you to think endearing about it. So when you say, Our Father, say, Our Father. You get breathing about it. He's your love with God in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Hallow his name. So I want you to think of just, he's your Father. He's our Father. I don't care what you've been through, Uncle, with your bracelets, he is Israel. At the background, he is our Father. He loves us. Our daddy, our Abba God. See, if you don't know, have a daddy, you know that what that longing for is a dear panic. I'm with my daddy. There's a place where there's so much love. There's a place where I can believe. There's a place where mercy covers me. There's a place within my Father's heart. There's a place where there's so much peace. There's a place where grace abounds towards me. There's a place where I can find my truth. There's a place, and everybody say, within my Father's heart. So you are in his heart.
didn't even hold back the blood of his only begotten son. Before the foundation of the world, he had you in mind. He is precise. It wasn't a Big Bang Theory. You didn't just happen to be here. He had you. When you came across the Middle Passages, when the Native Americans and you survived the smallpox, when you were abused by your daddy, he still had you in mind to bring you into the kingdom. So our Father, which art in heaven, and I sit in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, have your, bless the Lord with your imagination. Let your imagination take you there. So we're going to close with this. And as you you want to chime in and pray his name, I'm just going to pray as a world model, and I gave you a piece of paper to follow. I'm going to make sure you get one, because I know your heart, and you've been doing this with me and saying yes and amen. I'm thanking for that. I want to thank the Holy Spirit as well. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You called, allowed me to step in front of your vessels as a seed, because you want to harvest them to your glory, and they're going to go forth even more so. And I thank you for allowing me the time and be a window of heaven. They're awesome women of God. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for being in this place, and whatever I didn't do correctly, forgive me. And those areas that we need to learn more, Lord, I pray that their learning would continue. Our Father, which art in heaven, and we are the kingdom of heaven. Heal everywhere. The universe and within me. Hallowed be thy name, Jehovah Jireh, my provider. Jehovah Nissi, my banner. Jehovah Shalom, my peace. Peace with nothingness. Nothing broken. Said what I'm going to be. My El Elyon, my Elohim, my Daddy God, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Let your kingdom come, which is not meat or drink, but righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Thank you for putting me in right standing by the blood of God, giving me peace with God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Let your kingdom come, let your will, your word, whatever word that my sister needs this day, that my other sister needs this day, to be sufficient for this day. Let your kingdom come, let your will be done, which is your word, and your word is life, no matter what we're going through. On earth as it is in heaven. On earth and vessel, we say yes and amen to what you said in heaven before the foundation of the world. Even now, on earth in my life, as you said in heaven, in my life of my children, on earth as it is in heaven, as you predict, I put my agreement, my sister Versi said, we're commanding our day from heaven, as you said in heaven, right now. Give us this day, this manna, not yesterday's manna, was sufficient for this day. So I can give my children what's sufficient for the day. He's playing basketball. What does he need in his diet? My sister, my daughter who may be going to school, what does she need in her spiritual diet that I need to set her up for, so she's not set up for the enemy and he gives the ground? Give us this day what we need, God, because you are our source. We can't do it without you. Daddy God. And forgive us our trespasses. So, Lord, we don't want to be turned over to the tormentor. Forgive us for resentment, lying, backbiting, stealing, adultery, spiritual adultery, natural adultery, fornication, unforgiveness, fear, doubt. Forgive us, Lord. Don't let us be turned over to the tormentors. Forgive us, God, because we don't want nothing to separate you from. We want to be able to come into your presence, God. We thank you for the blood that gives us there. Forgive us this day. Forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. We don't want to be turned over to tormentors, so we forgive those past, present, and future, 70 times 7. We're not going to be ego-bound, not having pride they did something to me, because you are God, you are sovereign, you've allowed it. We thank you for the opportunity to show the kingdom of God and the Beatitudes principles. Lead us not into temptation. Be a fence around us, be a fortress garrison us, Father God. For we know in the heart of man there dwells well noble things, so we choose to die daily. Lead us not into temptation.
present an escape for us. Lead our children not into temptation, present an escape for them. Let a light surround them, let the love of God enfold them, let the power of God protect them, the presence of God be with them, the peace of God fill them, the joy of God flow from them. Deliver us from evil. You are our shepherd. And yea, though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death in this natural world, we shall fear no evil. And though many are the afflictions of the righteous, you hustle and get through to you. Deliver us out of all of them. Deliver us from evil. From even the filters that come. Deliver us from evil emotions, Father God. Deliver us from things, anything that does not bring your glory. So we can be at peace with you and cause any things that the enemy tried to make as our enemy to be at peace with us. Because to the pure, all things are pure. We want to do it your way, God. So that you can get the glory. All the power. All the glory. Hallelujah. The kingdom, the power, and of all the glory belongs to you. You alone are God, and beside you there is no other. Thank you for loving us. That you would even want to dwell in us. And to let us experience the kingdom. Know your power, the same power that raised Christ from the dead, and live in the kingdom. That from our bellies shall flow living waters, Lord. So they don't have to wait to revelations into heaven, but we become healing for the nations as we walk representing Christ in the earth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Dominion. Occupy until you come. Make us brides of Christ. And as they sang earlier today, Lord, I pray that this word would trim their lights. This word would be a trimming for their lights. I thank you, Lord, for everybody to participate. And you're so awesome, God. You know, I thought I was going to forget something. I have to go with my notes. You're awesome. Thank you for the wonderful teaching we have in this church. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. It's called Soul's Worth, and I also have one for if somebody dies in your family. It's a journal for the bereaved. But again, I thank you. I don't know. Crystal, I'll turn this over to you. Thank you.